This is KGW News at Sunrise.
Good morning and good to have you here with us on this Sunday. I'm Galen Etlin. The time now is 6 o'clock, and as the vaccine timeline moves up for many Oregonians, there are new options in Clackamas County. We're going to take you there to see these busy events. Plus another hurdle for restaurants in the pandemic. As they reopen to customers, some don't have the staff they need to serve them. But first, Keely Chalmers joins us live at home for our forecast. We are coming off that amazing day yesterday. I know there's some rain now in the forecast.
Yeah, it was a beautiful day yesterday. We do have quite a bit of rain in the forecast for today and a change in the temperature. Those temperatures are going to drop pretty drastically this evening. And yeah, the rain, low elevation snow. Let's take you outside right now, your Rose City Sky Cam, where we're starting to see the clouds overhead. We're sitting at 45 degrees right now. The wind's out of the northwest, 8 miles per hour. Those winds are going to ratchet up as we head into the afternoon. So here is how your Sunday is shaping up. Going to be right around 52 at noon. Not going to get much warmer than that. We'll probably top out in the mid 50s. And then we're going to cool down as some cold air moves in, going to bring us some rain, going to bring us the winds. But I'll tell you what, this is a very short-lived weather system. We've got a lot of sunshine and temperatures getting close to right around 70 in our 7-day forecast. We'll talk more about that coming up in just a bit.
Yeah. All right. Good to know, Keely. Thank you so much. All right, well, new this morning, this sounds like something out of a movie. Someone's recovering from this here today. Portland police tell us a car on I-405 crashed near the split to Highway 30, went off the overpass, and landed on the street below. Witnesses tell us it actually fell on top of two other cars. Police say there was only one person in that car, and that driver was seriously hurt and may not make it. We'll update you. Police are also investigating a shooting spree in North Portland's Elliott neighborhood. Police say Friday night, someone shot at the driver of a white Dodge. The shooter also hit two other parked cars. Now, the Dodge crashed into three parked cars as well. Luckily, that driver is okay. It's not clear why she was shot at either. There have not been any arrests yet. Let's turn now to the fight against COVID-19. The newest vaccination site in Clackamas County gave more than 2,000 COVID shots on Saturday alone. Our Devin Haskins has a look at that progress as eligibility timelines get moved up.
Probably the largest one in Clackamas County so far. We're going to have over 2,000 people getting their vaccinations today.
Hundreds drove through the different levels of the Clackamas Town Center parking garage on Saturday to receive their first dose of the Moderna vaccine.
So it's appointment only. They're coming in, they're being routed through here. Then we're using this four-story parking structure, and every floor is the same duplicated vaccine station.
Hello, I'm Natalie. I'm a nursing student from UP. I'm going to give your Moderna vaccine today.
22% of Clackamas County's population has been vaccinated, and more than 1 million Oregonians have received at least one shot. That's close to the national average.
I'm going to have you take a deep breath in and out.
Over 600,000 in the state have been fully inoculated.
I just got the shot and I feel good.
It was a very simple process, and I'm grateful now to have that first part done and be back in 2 weeks to get it finished up.
This was the second day in a row for the Clackamas Town Center site. Almost 1,500 were given out on Friday. On Wednesday, three more clinics around Clackamas County will open up.
You know, I'm just hoping that this is just going to contribute to the rest of, Oregon getting to a place where we can all get back to normal, basically.
Starting Monday, even more Oregonians will become eligible. They include adults 45 to 64 that have underlying conditions, agricultural, seasonal, and migrant workers, and those living in congregate situations and those that are homeless.
The general population will be eligible for a vaccine starting May 1st, and counties can apply to move up that date to April 26th if they meet certain requirements. The state says they will have enough vaccine supply for anyone who wants to get vaccinated by the end of May. At the Clackamas Town Center, I'm Devin Haskins, KGW News.
So let's really break down those eligibility timeline changes that were announced on Friday here. On April 5th, you might remember, frontline workers got moved up along with those in multi-generational homes and any adult with an underlying condition. And this is all 2 weeks earlier than originally planned. Several other new groups are also eligible in Oregon starting tomorrow. That's anyone 45 and older with an underlying condition, farm and food processing workers, people who are homeless, and those who are pregnant. Now, if you're not sure what group you fall into, we've got the full list on KGW.com. Washington, meanwhile, is also moving ahead with its vaccine effort. 2 million more people will become eligible on Wednesday. Now, that includes anyone 60 years or older, anyone 16 and over with two or more comorbidities, and people working in congregate living settings like prisons, group homes, and homeless shelters. Also included are high-risk critical workers in congregate settings such as restaurants, food services, and construction. Coronavirus restrictions are easing up and restaurants everywhere are starting to reopen, but their struggles are not over. Some face new challenges of finding workers. They're having a hard time staying open because they're understaffed. They say one issue is that potential workers don't want to risk getting COVID.
You need that fresh energy and fresh bodies coming in so that you can have everyone well rested and getting through those hot summer days, and it's and enjoying yourself. Like, you know, we want to be able to go and float the river this summer too. So finding that work-life balance, that comes with beefing up your staff.
With the summer season approaching, some restaurants are trying to hire for all positions ahead of time. The American Rescue Plan, COVID relief package rather, could get you money for health insurance. More than 51,000 uninsured Oregonians can get new tax credits to help pay for health plans, and 7,400 are eligible for free coverage altogether. The income threshold is expanding eligibility. Families of four making under $150,000 or individuals making under $76,000 can get in on those subsidies.
So there's a whole population of Oregonians who are eligible for coverage who are not taking advantage of it.
So think after the year that everyone has had, healthcare priorities have really changed.
I think we all think about healthcare in a different way than we used to. You know, we are all invested in that now.
People can apply through OregonHealthcare.gov starting April 1st through August 15th. People interested in Washington can visit the Washington Health Benefit Exchange website. Well, people who are homeless in Portland and living in RVs are now getting some help from the city. The Bureau of Environmental Services launched a pilot program dealing with waste. KGW's Mike Benner learned how it will work.
In certain pockets of North Portland, really in many places across the city, you'll find RVs providing shelter to the houseless.
In a stressful living condition, going to a disposal site, which are few and far between, can be difficult.
Diane Dolkin says Portland's Bureau of Environmental Services is making it less difficult with its pilot pump-out program. Once a week, the city will go to an area with a high concentration of RVs and pump out the waste.
The goal is, can we pump out the service, prevent discharges to storm drains, Green Street planters, the street, other places that affect our environment and people.
Dolkin says the program launched last week. Crews serviced a total of 10 RVs across three different neighborhoods. They hope to eventually drain 7,500 gallons of waste out of 20 RVs a week.
Most importantly, our goal is to prevent discharges to the environment. So, right, pollution prevention is a far better option than cleanup.
Portland City Commissioner Mingus Mapps agrees. He said this about the pilot program. I am proud of Environmental Services for stepping up to a growing need and providing services in a respectful, dignified way for our houseless community, as well as protecting our rivers and waterways from human waste. And at the end of the day, that's something everybody can get behind.
We see an immediate need that we are delivering to benefit the community, protect the environment, and serve among our most vulnerable population, people who do not have reliable housing.
All right, this pilot program is modeled after a similar program in Seattle. We can also tell you that Portland's Bureau of Environmental Services has a budget of $10,000 to run this program through June and evaluate what comes next. I'm Mike Benner for KGW News.
All right, here's a big update here. The Oregon State Beavers are moving on in the NCAA tournament. The Beavs beat Loyola Chicago on Saturday 65-58. The win sends them to the Elite Eight for the first time since 1982. They'll play the Houston Cougars on Monday night. The winner goes to the Final Four. Meanwhile, the Oregon Ducks men and women will play later today, and both hope for a chance at the Elite Eight as well. The women will face second seed Louisville today at 4 o'clock. The Cardinals are 25-3 in the season. The Oregon men will tip off at 6:45 tonight. They're playing a familiar opponent from the Pac-12, USC. The Trojans beat the Ducks last month during the Pac-12 regular season.